Hey everyone, this is Wrecker, back with another build. So the one that I'm sharing with you guys today is an insanely good backfire build. Of course, we are fully immune to bleed effect, but we also have 80% hazard protection overall. But this isn't just any other backfire build. With a bunch of hazard protection stocked up and very mediocre damage numbers. No, we are talking over 1.2 million body crits and over 1.4 million head crits on full stacks. And yeah, this is for me, makes it really special. So not only we are fully immune to bleed, but also hitting insanely high damage numbers. So yeah, with that being said, please like the video, subscribe to the channel if you haven't already, and let's begin. Okay, so starting off with the specialization, of course we are running Gunner. It's giving us 10% armor on kill, then we have every third reload 50% faster. Then we have an armor kit which not only gives our armor back but 30% bonus armor for 10 seconds, that's really handy. Then of course we have the Banshee Pulse which unlocks with this specialization, and yes, we are running this in this setup, so that's really good. Then we have 10% total ammo, regenerating every 60 seconds for us, but 5% for the whole group, so that's really helpful. Then we have some weapon handling, then we have 5% increased rate of fire after a kill for 5 seconds. So these are insanely good numbers when it comes to gunner specialization. Lastly, make sure in the weapons tree you have stacked up damage in the right weapon types that you're running in the setup. For me, that's the SMG of course and the shotgun. So yeah, this is the spec we're running. Okay, so starting off with the weapons, of course we are running the Backfire. This is the weapon the entire setup is built around. It comes with SMG damage, critical hit chance, and 12% magazine size. The talent that it comes with, it's called Payment in Kind. Dealing damage to enemies at a stack of 1%, critical hit damage up to 200 stacks, lasting 10 seconds. So basically what's happening is, if you're hitting the enemy, it doesn't have to be a crit. You just have to hit the enemy 200 times, any enemy at all, and it will give you 200% critical hit damage on full stacks. But there is a caveat. If you reload the weapon and if you don't have any hazard protection or if you're not immune to bleed, it's gonna put that bleed effect on you. As you see, the bottom part says on reload, apply a 10 second bleed to yourself, which deals 0.5% armor damage per stack. And on 200 stacks, that can actually kill you. I have tested this out. So, but we don't have to worry about that because as I said in the intro, we are fully immune to bleed effect along with 80% hazard protection in general. So we are good. So that's the primary weapon, of course. You might see I am upgraded to plus 10% weapon damage. By the way, a quick tip in there, you don't have to spend any exotics in case you want to upgrade your weapon or any gear to 10%. So just to guys let you know, in case you don't know, you don't have to spend any exotics. So yeah, mine is upgraded to level 10, so that's why you see 10% weapon damage in addition. So that's why as a base number we are sitting at 127.5k on the base number. Then we have 978 RPM and a mag of 56. So yeah, this is the primary weapon we'll be running at. The secondary doesn't really matter. For me, I'm running a fully maxed out KSG shotgun in case I need to use it, but I never do. So use what you prefer. For the sidearm, as always, I'm running my trusty Orbit to gain even more critical hit chance and critical hit damage bonus numbers whenever I need to. So basically, I have to kill an enemy and swap to my primary weapon to get this buff. We're getting 35 crit chance, 40% crit damage. These are insanely good numbers. And on full stacks, you'll be hitting 300% crit damage if you play the build the right way using this sidearm. But this is what I have. You can use whatever you prefer. Okay, so starting off with the gear pieces, you can see we are running 4-piece strikers. Yes, this is the key here with this build and the reason why we are able to hit such high numbers with our backfire. That's because of striker gear set. So the 2-piece gets us 15% weapon handling, 3-piece gets us 15% rate of fire. The 4-piece is the main talent for the gear set. It's called Striker's Gamble. Weapon hits increase total weapon damage by 0.65%, stacking up to 100 times. 1 stack lost per second between 0 to 50, 2 stacks between 50 to 100. Now, this is the key here. Since we are running 4-piece striker, including the backpack here, as you can see, it's called risk management. It's going to increase our weapon damage from 0.65% to a whole 1%. So basically, on full stacks, we will be getting 100% multiplicative weapon damage. So that's really good. As for the attributes, by the way, this will be the entire team theme for the whole setup. We are running weapon damage as the core attributes, all 6 pieces, and hazard protection along with crit chance and crit damage wherever we can. So you can see here, for the mod slot, I'm running a bleed resistant mod. Yes, we're gonna be using at least 2 bleed resistance mods to complete our build, because if you run hazard protection on all 6 species, which you have to, you get 10% from your shade watch, you will be needing at least 20% more to be fully immune from the bleed effect and be at that 100%. So yeah, for me, I only needed 2 mods, but if you're lacking somewhere, you're gonna have to use 3 bleed resistance mods to be fully immune. So just to put it out there. So as you can see here, core attribute, weapon damage, 10% hazard protection, then 10% bleed resistance as a mod. Same thing for the mask for strikers, weapon damage, hazard protection, and then I have a 6% crit chance mod in there. Same thing for the knee pads, weapon damage and hazard protection. And lastly, same thing for the holster, weapon damage and hazard protection. Okay, so for the chest piece, I'm running a Cheska piece. The only reason because I'm not running a Sokolov and running a Cheska is because I want to be fully maxed out on our critical hit chance, so we could crit more often instead of having 10% more damage, which, by the way, it can hit even higher than that if you want to switch over to Sokolov, but then again, you won't be critting as much, because if you don't use Cheska as one of the pieces on this setup, your critical hits are gonna fall off, as per my testing. So yeah, that's the reason I'm running Cheska. So brand bonus gonna give you 10% crit chance, then we have weapon damage, critical hit chance, hazard protection, and then again another 10% bleed resistance mod in there. For the Talon that I'm running on the chest piece, of course, my favorite talent to run for any crit builds, obliterate. Critical hits increase total weapon damage by 1% for 5 seconds, stacks up to 25 times. So it's gonna give us 25% weapon damage on crits on full stacks. So yeah, this is really good. So if you want to use any other talent, that's your personal preference. But for this build, for me, this is the best talent to run. So yeah, this is the chest piece we're running. And finally, the last piece to complete the entire build is a very special one, because it's not very easy to get. Yes, if you get lucky, Yawl gear sometimes appears in the clan vendor that I have seen. It might pull up on some of the other vendors, but I'm not entirely certain. But you can pick it up from there or from the dark zone, or you can craft it from your crafting bench. Yes, but that only is possible if you have some Yawl materials in your inventory already. So that's really important. So you have to find 1 Yawl piece. You can stack it up anywhere in the build, you know, it doesn't have to be a glove, so you can put it anywhere, but it has to be 1 Yawl piece, because it's gonna give you 10% hazard protection as a brand bonus. Then we have the same attributes as the other pieces: weapon damage, hazard protection, crit hit damage. So yeah, this is really important. So you have to have 1 Yawl piece in there, which is gonna put you at 100% bleed resistance as per my stats. So yeah, this is the glove we're running. Okay, so starting off with the skills, of course, as I said in the intro, from the gunner specialization, we are running the Banshee pulse. That's really handy because most of the time we are just running and gunning and in enemies' faces, so having them disoriented most of the time is really helpful. So yeah, that's the reason we're running the Banshee pulse. For the mods, I'm running 50% radius and 6% skill haste to get it back as fast as possible. For our second skill, of course, I'm running the shield. Yes, it's a run and gun build. We will be face tanking enemies most of the time, So a shield is really handy. It's basically another health bar on top of your armor. So I would highly recommend running a shield. For the mods, I'm running shield health on two of slots and then 5% damage bonus. So yeah, these are the skills I'm running. Okay, so before I jump in to the overview for the entire build, let me show you the stats real quick for the backfire. We are sitting at 127k weapon damage as a base. We have 58% critical hit chance and 62% critical hit damage here. Now, these are only base numbers, goes without saying, because our main goal is to reach that 200% critical hit damage from the backfire, which is going to put us at 262% in total on full stacks. And if you use the orbit during your combat, it's going to put you at an additional 40% critical hit damage from that weapon. So keep that in mind. Then we have 70% headshot damage, but these are all offensive numbers. Let me show you the hazard numbers we're running. As you can see, we are sitting at 80% hazard protection in general. So 80% throughout the board for all status effects, right? But the main goal here is this, bleed resistance. We are fully immune 100% from bleed effect here. So that was the main goal here. Being immune to bleed effect completely, but also hitting insanely high numbers on our build with our backfire. So yeah, these are the stats for the entire build. Okay, so this is the entire build, everyone. We are running the gunner specialization. As a primary, we're running the backfire. For the secondary, I'm running a KSG shotgun. For the sidearm, I'm running the orbit. For the gear pieces, we are running 4-piece strikers, including the backpack. 1-piece yawl gear on the glove slot. And lastly, I'm running the Cheska chest with the talent obliterate. For the skills, I'm running the Banshee Pulse and also the Crusader Shield. So yeah, this is the full build, everyone. If you have any questions, let me know in the comment section below. And with that being said, please like the video, subscribe to the channel for more videos, and I'll see you in the next one. See ya.